Good evening and welcome to election night coverage as we continue to check in with you about every half an hour or so. Polls closed in Illinois and Missouri about 90 minutes ago. I'm Mark Maxwell alongside Anita Mannion. We're still watching and waiting. We have a lot faster results reporting in Chicago than we do in St. Louis and the surrounding area right now.
Yeah, definitely.
We'll have to check with our election officials and give them some ribbing later on. Come on, we want to see the info. We do have some early results scrolling across your screen, but we've been watching these marijuana results. It looks like the support is pretty strong. I don't know if it surprises folks. It's about commensurate with what we saw for overall support of the constitutional amendment, around 70%. We're seeing, you know, with some variation based on which city or county you're in, most people want to see the city government or the county government where they live benefit from the sale of recreational marijuana, it looks like.
I think that's right. I think for people who maybe didn't have a stake in marijuana being legalized, that idea that if folks are going to be consuming this product, then the municipality should get that tax revenue.
And we were discussing with you, if you've been watching with us periodically throughout the night, all you need is 50% of the vote plus one vote to secure passage or the authorization of this local sales tax. You could see it at 3% for the city where you live. You could see another 3% for the county where you live, potentially in St. Louis County, that's happening.
Right.
And that's on top of a 6% sales tax. So if all of those stack on top, the maximum marijuana tax for recreational, not medicinal marijuana, would reach 12% in Missouri. And that's still 4 points lower than what it is in Illinois.
It is. And, you know, the product itself has been found to be more affordable in Missouri than Illinois and other Midwest states. And it's one reason that sales really exceeded expectations. I think in the first 30 days in Missouri, over $72 million in recreational sales of marijuana occurred. So I think the municipalities, the counties really started saying, that's a lot of tax revenue we can bring in. We saw St. Louis County estimating $3.5 million they could bring in.
And the county spent $300,000 in government money to put up this big PR campaign and persuade voters to support this idea. They did so hoping they'd get return on their investment and get about that $3.5 million in annual revenue coming in to help the budget. Speaking of return on investment, there is no better election to cast your ballot because you'll make a bigger difference, 100%. Almost certainly in a local race than you will in a federal race. There's just fewer people out there voting. You can have a bigger impact with your vote.
And we saw this in the primaries with one of the Board of Aldermen races being tied until just a handful of provisional ballots decided it. And so, yes, I always encourage people, turn out in these local elections. You're going to be in and out in just a minute. Your vote makes a real impact. And these are issues that affect our everyday lives, whether it's your school board, the potholes in your street, all the issues that we worry about.
If you notice me checking my phone feverishly, I'm looking for text messages or any leads from election officials. We're watching all signs. We're told that there could be another batch or a big dump of counted ballots reported from election officials as we learn more about where these races stand. We're watching a number of close races in the city of St. Louis to determine. Remember, the Board of Aldermen is shrinking from 28 down to 14 members. So it was really bruising. I don't know if there was an uglier race than the one we saw in the northern part of the city, the new 14th ward, between Ebony Washington and Rasheen Aldridge there. Things just got really intense. Does that speak to the character of the candidates or the intensity of the race?
I think, you know, close races can get pretty intense. I would hate to cast aspersions on the character of the candidates, but it might have to do with, you know, the social media battles and ways that we have of communicating. And overall, we see politicians in the last couple of years engaging in maybe a little less decorum than we've seen in the past. So maybe not that surprising. There have been a few races with some controversy, whether it's sort of that back and forth or people alleging that folks don't have the right to run, whether it's property taxes or where they live. So there's been quite a bit of controversy in these Board of Aldermen races.
We saw a few campaigns try to boot their opponent from the ballot in court. It wasn't always successful. There was only one uncontested race in those ward races. But again, you're going to continue seeing all these results tick across your screen. And on KSDK.com/elections, you will also see those results. The next time we're going to check in with you is in about half an hour from now, 25 minutes or so at the top of the 9 o'clock hour. And if our sources are correct, we do expect that we should have some decisive results that should give us a better idea where things go. We're waiting and standing by any minute for that.